Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about one sub, two sub, three sub. A lot of people have called me and sent me emails saying, well, Dennis, if we add more subs and more energies at different locations in the room, we can smooth out frequency response. This is a good example of a half truth. Yes, that's partially true, and no, it's not true at all. So we're going to talk about the two differences here. So yes, we can look at the response curve and we see that most of our energy in the low frequency areas in small rooms, and I have a database of 135 rooms, 137 now built and measured. Most show a 10 to a 15 dB bump, less than 100 cycles. Standard characteristic, standard bell shape curve for low frequencies in small rooms. Can we reduce the bump by adding more energy to the room and thus balancing out the pressure in the room? Yes, we can. We may have a bump this big with one subwoofer. If we put two, it decreases a little bit. If we put three, it smooths out. But here's the half truth. Even that is too large. If we're starting with a 15 dB bump, we add three subwoofers, we might reduce that 6-7 dB. But that's still unacceptable in terms of a frequency response curve in critical listening rooms, control rooms, mix rooms, even live rooms. So is adding more subwoofers a way to smooth out the low and below 100 cycles of a response curve? Yes and no. Yes, it reduces it, but no, not enough. So you have to look at the cost versus the benefit. I don't know if you've priced subwoofers these days, but the ones we use can be $3,000 to $5,000 retail each. If you're going to add three to a room, you could be $10,000 to $15,000. I think you'd be better off spending that money on low frequency treatment, finding a larger room, and therefore not having to deal with this kind of situation at all if you had the right room size. And $15,000 in low frequency treatment can go a long way. In our rooms, we shoot for a plus or minus 1 dB across the board from 25 cycles on up. We guarantee it from 30. So this is a good example of the half-truths that we deal with in room acoustics. Will adding more pressure to small rooms smooth out the response? Yes, but not enough. And the cost versus the benefit of doing that, you'd be best to find a larger room or spend the money on treatment. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website and there's a book now button so you can book a appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.